Hello. The coming days might not be very good days to policy development because it's getting really hot in Holland. So, and since I don't have any good air conditioning here, might not be the optimal environment to work, where you have to concentrate quite a bit. So, but anyways, I'm going to try it. But I'm going to start with tying some loose ends, or at least some suspected loose ends, because in the previous episode I confined at least partly the what was it, that BitTorrent client, and I suspect that I overlooked some stuff that might just be worth fixing now instead of basically leaving that for later. So I'll just to run SMDB to expose hidden denials and try to fix those two if I'm actually right. And after that we'll see what happens if we go ahead. There are some other things to consider. We're hitting some bumps. Okay, so I'm gonna log in. I should have basically cleared the directory, but I haven't, so I'll just do this manually. Basically, I'll remove this. And we are in a force mode, aren't we? Yeah. So basically, I need to go back to Fedora. Probably best to just where are you, my the editor? So basically running that app. Then open a URL. Oh, it's actually in there. Nice. At least that allows me to and then just open it and download it again. Because I've got this, but you can actually open the folder here, so, and there's actually other stuff here. But the open folder is one of these things that I'd like to take care of. So I'll just do that, because I now already confirmed that that's something that we need to basically take care of. And it's pretty easy to fix. So, what's this app called again? Transmission. And it's pretty easily solved. Basically, it runs Nautilus. That fixes that. supposedly. Although there might be some deepest chatting. Fortunately, there's a little wind, it's getting a little windy. A breeze, summer breeze. So this is all pretty much expected. There are some things that I'm wondering about with regard to transmission. Especially with regard to it creating content to use a home door, that doesn't seem complete to me. Why is my upstream so limited? Probably some config option. Not much with regard to transmission at all. All seems looks well. Less. Yeah, I can do that, but that makes sense. It seems to work. It's pretty strange. I'm doing center 4.0 right now, just to make sure that this works, because there's probably going to be some DBIS chatting going on here. So open the folder, should be opening the folder in Nautilus, and it does. So let's see if there's something new involved with that. Yeah. Not much, but this is, it's weird. No, this is not this one. So now to this config home here. So you have this file, and it basically wants to read and get attributes. So Yeah, obviously, it's always good to just double check. There's always something missing. But also, let's see if we have some deeper stuff. Not here, at least. Actually, not here either. So there's no Debus chatting going on here. Now, there are just some things that, verify local data. Might want to do that. This is still not actually doing anything with regard to that. But yeah, it's kind of weird. But we really need to make sure that that it's actually also probably also related to the rule. Where is it? Here. So basically, it's allowed to search, get attribute, read, open, user home type, DIRS. And that is also user home T. So that's probably why. The weird thing is that it should be adding entries to this user home T. That's actually allowed here. So yeah, I guess that's it then. It seems weird, but I guess that's just it. But we did actually manage to fix something. For example, this Nautilus stuff here. But also we actually allowed it to run Nautilus. Let's see if I can actually edit it. Doesn't seem there's no speed limits. There are some things that are actually you have a web client. this stuff is not supported. Although it could support that at some point, but that's a bad idea. This is basically running a web server, I guess. See, the fact that you can just specify IP addresses means that it's actually going to serve on the networks. So I'm not going to support that right now. If someone needs that support, then he can go out and do it himself. Yeah, it all seems proper. This stuff is all supposed to be don't audit it. Although transmission really wants to, for some reason, actually list the user, the home root there, but I'm not going to allow that. And it will bark in enforce mode. It will bark if it can't list the slash home. But it doesn't seem to actually break anything. So you'll get a message. Not allowed to error, not allowed to read slash home. But when you click on click OK, then everything seems to go forward properly. Let's try this. And this actually does do some stuff. Trash. So yeah, we actually figured out some stuff that we need to take care of. Let's just search for trash, because we need to do that with a transition. Transmission. So yeah, there's a lot of stuff that you basically need to test. It won't work. And then there's some stuff with regard to reparenting this here. Let's just put this here for now, and then just add the create here, and yeah, we'll move that here. Basically the same rule, but then just append it. See, I was actually looking at it, and I thought by myself, only create, that doesn't look all that complete. But then I figured out that it's already allowed to at least list and traverse that there with a rule above where basically I allow that to user home type there, which also user home to is also user home type there. So I thought, okay, now that might be well. But then I just started try to delete transmission to delete it, and then I all of a sudden saw these. So now it's actually at least a confirmation that. Oh, and now let's also still look for trilog messages, and we have some sent messages here. We have actually G session and GFS metadata. So let's just make that a tail. And about, I guess 50 is fine. And I have to allow, and then let's see if the output is as I expect. Yeah, it's pretty much as I expect. So it's actually chatting. You see, that's really a good idea to just take your time and test that stuff thoroughly, because else then there's going to be loose ends, and there's always going to be loose ends even if you test it thoroughly. There's always some exception somewhere. But that doesn't mean that you shouldn't try and fix those from the get-go. So GVFS metadata. There's still stuff that we haven't actually tested it, but I'm pretty convinced that that will work. Like for example, loading a local torrent file. Because it is allowed to get pretty much access to generic user home content. Weird thing is that previously I had that create the there button, but I guess it's just not applicable here. And that's probably why it's not showing it. Well, there are some things that I'm not going to go into right now. So that's, yeah, this probably, oh, yeah. See, it's unlimited currently. So, yeah, that's possibly, yeah, looks okay. Looks okay. So yeah, we're basically now back at a point where we need to figure out something new to confine, and there are some things to consider. Let's just restore con rvf home, my login user. Just have a look at what it resets or what might not be labeled properly. Cache, music, and then you have this stuff here. And this is actually a thing that we should take care of. See if how we can do that. I'm not actually sure. So we have this trash. Where have we trash? Here. Paste that in. Files. And then. Basically, we need to tell. As in Linux, that it should not try and relabel stuff in there. Not sure if that is a really smart thing to do. But only for files, I guess. Not sure if this is a smart thing to do. How do I actually do that? Seem to have forgotten about that. Okay, so how do I, I'm trying to look that up, so let's just try to use the Fedora as a Linux site. Not sure where I should look for that, probably either files or the user domain. Let's just have a look at the user domain first. I'm looking for the specification to specify that it shouldn't. Yeah, here we have it. This is it. This is old, by the way. Because this stuff ain't even no longer in user home dirs, and hasn't actually set GVFS is now in this dir here. So kind of old. That needs to be changed. But anyways. And it's actually not this, it's actually this. It shows that actually build spot. So basically we're telling SE Linux, don't try to reset these files there. And that's these. But actually, That's it. Also dos. So that's messy. So that's not right. This is not right. I need to do it all over again. Or not all over again, but I need to make this anything in there. Then you'll get a problem though. Let's think about that for a second. Well, actually, that should be fine. So let's just change the contacts back to use a home T. Same for this stuff here. This looks nice. So now let's try and reset that again. Warning, no default label. Yeah, that's cool. Why is that a warning? Okay, that's cool. So now, let's have a look at, and first I'll click the screen here. So what it does, it doesn't actually delete the files, it just sends them to trash. And then basically what I'm going to do is now find audit logs for 11 o'clock. And then see if trash basically does that properly. This track minor FS, yeah, this sucks. It shouldn't actually be audio home T. But then basically empty the trash. Look at that. Seems to look fine. Yeah, this can be ignored. This mother wants to basically actually traverse SSH home. Yeah. Middle finger to you. Hell no. That's none of your business. And then you get that new document. Let's see what that gives me. Nothing, so that works. Okay, so that works as well. What nice. So yeah, that's pretty much done. So on to that next thing that we need to do. So there's really not much left in the default apps to confine, except the backup program. This one, backup. But that program requires stuff. Like for example, it requires TPG. It requires, if you want to backup using SSH, it probably requires PKI if you use PKI for authentication. So, really, before we need to get into that, we probably just need to make sure that we can authenticate and use our keys. And that's app is basically this app here, with Skull. Keys and things, passwords and keys. So I'm just gonna try and actually I'm gonna set it for one and try and run it and then use the AV signal to see what it is. Set it for one, try and run that app and then I can see what it's trying to run. So it's denied. Seahorse, user bin Seahorse. This I can quit. Also this dismissed. So it's usually been seahorse, but just let's just confirm. Execute seahorse. So that means that we're going to have to deal with that. So use a bin seahorse. Seahorse. Yeah. So the seahorse is actually executed by shell. Have some other Nautilus stuff, but I can't reproduce that somehow. Seahorse. We need to be careful here though. Although I'm pretty sure that it does run Yelp. But we can't just blindly make assumptions. Yeah, Yeah, this is going to be another big ass project because I want to basically redo the various SSH keygen and and TPT. I want to basically redo that because it's a little bit too coarse currently in my view. But yeah, to do that is a lot of work, but it's for me it's important. I really think that integrity of GPT is just vital, of vital importance. You know, if you use GPT right, and you, yeah, if you do it right, then that's basically one of the few things that can safeguard your privacy and protection. Then you'll have to do it right, and not just from as a Linux point of view. I need to restore con user bin seahorse. User bin seahorse, and hopefully that's not a link. Doesn't seem to be a link. And then send it for 0, and then just going to do that. But first of all, regarding user u, I should never allow user u to use sudo anyways. Either. Okay, so we need to go ahead and do seahorse. Let's just start it. We are in permissive mode, yeah, right, we are. So we started seahorse, so let's see what that brings us. At 11:24. Really a slow day again. And it's probably going to span a couple episodes, this stuff, because yeah, you see here it's already doing all kinds of shit. Let's just take care of this here. Alright, so first things first. So, TKRD all of a sudden wants to do stuff that it didn't need to do previously. Let's see. TKRD wants to actually read other states, as far as I know. I guess not. So let's just add this in here. And we can basically add that as is. So this is basically reading state, but we need to edit that a little bit. Let's have a look at how that's done. Because here this user needs to read its own state. And that's basically kinda like this here. But not quite. Here, no. Should be here somewhere. Here it is. I'll just copy this off. Yeah, I'll just copy it over. And use that as inspiration. So yeah, it wants to actually, and I'll just use the get attribute and search here for dir. If it wants to read that dir, listed dir, then I'll see later. But it really needs to read that file and get attribute and open that file. So yeah, that's just something that you, I can remove this now. And it actually needs to list cert dirs. But with regard to seahorse, we can't do much. We just need to see the transitions. And you can actually see already a bunch of transitions here. You can see that it actually runs GPG, so we actually need a transition to GPG. And it runs something that's currently generic, so let's just grab execute. GPG, and then there's GPG conf, which is currently generic. So that's probably not. TPG conf is a utility to automatically and reasonably safely query and modify configuration files. So this is actually probably not run by Seahorse. Let's have a look. Yeah, it is actually run by Seahorse. But if I create a private type for this, then that might break things. See if I can find that one. Not sure, but I think this is also a series. Alright, so I still don't know what to do about this issue here. I know it needs to transition, but should I? It's hard to say. Should I create a type for gpt-conf or should I? Have another look what it's running. gpt2, yeah, it's just executing gpt2 and gpt-conf. I'm going to just create a policy for gpt-conf as well. Because might actually be needed. GPG. Now these are both executed by seahorse. GPG. And then all this. First I'll do the seahorse stuff. GPG stuff. It's a tad messy. Okay. Now, with regard to the executable file, it's not quite that straightforward. So I'll just copy this over first. And take care of this one first, because this type gpg-conf or gpg-exact is already there, so we can just remove this and require type gpg-exact. But this is actually something we need to. This is a new type, a new executable file type. So it's actually this is a bug. Man, oh man. Okay, that's done. Now I need to make sure that if it builds that I restore the context. I need to log out. And do my dance. And we removed that GPG. GNUPG. Let's just also add that. Actually, let's not do that. Okay, so that seems to be okay. I'll search. We're clean. Oh, guys, guys, guys. Oh, I need to proceed because I need to get through that stuff. A lot of work to be done. Yeah, actually GPG doing it. So at least the transition to GPG works, but I would have expected GPT conf to do that, so I'm not sure what's happening here. All right, so where are we? Let's just make sure that. Oh yeah, we need to try the have a look at GPT. Grab GPT. It's actually GPT doing that stuff. So how the hell? That's so weird. Let's grab GPT conf. Seems. So weird. Then what the hell does GPT conf do? Executes it, but it doesn't do anything. Weird indeed. So yeah, GPG just creates it there, so we need to take care of that. Sometimes so tiresome. It's really going slow. Now let's first just add a type transition. Oh, and require secret GPT secret key. Require GPT secret key. I don't have time for that stuff. If it's good for you, then it's fine with me. GPT secret D, and then the name is GNU PG. So what it needs to do is basically add, oh, and I'll just copy this over. It needs to write and add name and search. Add name and write, and and now we need to actually allow it to basically traverse. Yeah, sooner or later it's going to want to get attributes as well. So yeah, this should be a start. It's going really, really, really slow. We need to make sure with regard to seahorse that we took all the executes out first. Seems we have. And then go do our thing again. It's the same old drill. So it's deconfined empty, so we can take that there. We can take this and deconfined empty probably also. Yeah. So just paste this in and go through this first. Yeah, we need to basically first take care of GPG and stuff, because else can't basically make a secure backup, as far as I know. I haven't actually done that often, but I guess this is going to be a good opportunity to do it. So this can be removed, this can be removed, this can be removed, this can be removed. Then we have a traversal. Home the T here, this one, and this one can be removed. And here it's actually seahorse is actually reading SSH. And we can remove, we should remove this SSH file. So I'll just remove this from now. For now. We should just remove that. And we can remove the signal inheritance, no at secure and stuff. That's basically what we need to deal with. So we have fonts, we have X server. Where is it stuff? We need a graphical user application actually. Here we have the X server stuff. And yeah, the fonts, I'll copy these over. Yeah, we probably also need to edit other stuff. But first things first, this is just going to be a long project again. So just need to do it step by step. It's important that we get this right. So yeah. Once I get these basics out of the way, I'm just going to take a break and then we'll just spend another, at least one other episode on this stuff, if not two. I'm not going to do this all in one episode. No need. So, fonts, with the care of fonts. We take care of X server, which is this one. And these. Actually, this I'm going to remove it, but this might not actually. We might actually need to be allow it to read ACM home. So we have a system. Bus stream connect here, so that means, and we have that elsewhere as well, but where we had that nice grouped stuff. Just don't know where. One of the last things I guess that we did. So much polish to sift through. Here it is. This is a block of rules that is basically all related. And in that case was it was for printing, but in this case it's yeah, probably for the keyring daemon. Actually that doesn't make sense either. That's for something, not sure what it is, but it wants to basically connect to the system bus for whatever reason. This is all. This is with regard to connecting to keyring daemon. This is in run user, but we already allow it to search temps, so that should take care of that. This is connected to the session, user session bus, and here we have data empty, which also means that it also needs to get attributes. And search tconfine. So I can just add that in here. Tconfine. Because you can't get to data if you can't get to tconfine. And then here we have config home search, but this is also already taken care of for deconf here. So yeah, we have some of the basics out of the way. Let's have a look at last var log messages for any yeah, we have seahorse chatting to GKRD and to GVFSD. We have a lot of bunch of stuff. We can take care of these. It's actually far from complete. But let's just take that. And just add that here. And I'll just add a sent message here. The sooner or later, it's probably going to need that. They all need it, so why wouldn't? And this is single way, of course, because it's to the user session bus. But this is bidirectional. And there was also GVFS, and why didn't it list that? I would have sworn they had it also. Oh. Maybe. Yeah, GVFS to Seahorse. I thought 100 lines, so is 100 lines not enough? No, it's not enough. So you can see that actually I need to really be careful. But yeah, this is probably just it. I don't think applications like GPG actually chat, but I'll make a note of it, and if it turns out that in some of these next tests GPG actually tries to chat to XP and stuff like that, then that I should remove that or at least double check that. But yeah, I don't think that GPG actually does deal with chatting. So this is taken care of, this is taken care of, but these two we need to take care of. So I'm just going to basically make I'm logged off already. Types. Hello, please cooperate. Install. Then clear the home directory and stuff like that. Log off. it all. I'm going to also remove the SSH there now. We added that back in the back then for logging in via SSH. So this should be fixed in the next run. Okay. So I'm going to take a break right about now.